In today's video, I show you how to install Wine and Box 64 in Proot Distro to be able to run Windows programs in our Linux. As a base, I am going to use the Debian distribution to install everything we are going to need. Keep in mind that many Windows programs will not be able to run or will fail, so it is a matter of trial and error. The first thing will be to open our Debian environment. I leave you a video of how to install it if you have not arrived still until this stage. For this video, we will follow all the procedure described in Yvonne's blog. I leave the link in the description of the video, but basically, we will follow step by step everything he tells us. Let's go to the section where it says Install Box 86 and Box 64. The first part of logging into the Proot environment has already been done, so let's copy the first command to install Box 86. Paste it into the terminal and wait for everything to install. When it finishes, as you can see, I get a red error message, but the process is really complete, so we are not going to pay attention to it. We repeat the procedure with Box 64, and we will see again the same message in red, but we do not pay attention to it and move on to the next step. Next, we are going to install Wine both the 32-bit version and the 64-bit version. We copy the first command to install all the necessary dependencies and paste it in the terminal. We continue, and as before, we copy the command to start the installation of Wine and paste it into the terminal. This time, we will not have any error message. We continue with the following command to extract the downloaded files and move them to the corresponding folders. Now we are going to create the shortcuts to launch Wine automatically with the corresponding box version, i.e. 32 or 64 bits. We finish the Wine installation by exporting the necessary paths and install WineTrix, a Wine utility for installing certain DLLs and managing the program configuration. Finally, we are going to create a shortcut on the desktop for the Wine Explorer utility. With this, we will open from the desktop a Wine File Explorer where we can comfortably select our file with .exe extension and run it to start the installation process. In the tutorial, it is also indicated how to install DXVK for the hardware acceleration with Wine, but honestly, I am not clear how it works and I have not been able to test it, so I have decided to omit it in this video. If you have information about it, leave it in the comments. We have already finished the installation, so let's test if everything works. For this, we are going to try to install the Notepad++ program. You can go to the official page to download it from Yvonne's blog. We download the 32-bit and 64-bit versions, although I'm going to test directly with the 64-bit version for convenience. In the Notepad++ page, we go to the Download tab and select the version we want to test. Now we open the Explorer of Wine that we have in the desktop for the version that we have downloaded, in my case the one of 64 bits. When the Explorer opens, a message will appear and we click on Install. We will simply wait a while for the whole process to finish, and we will have everything configured properly. Now we are going to look for the path where we have the .exe files that we have downloaded, and we double-click to start the installation process. Keep in mind that it may take a while to open the program, so I recommend you to have some patience. When the installer opens, we simply click Next all the time until the installation process is finished. I recommend you to check that the program starts when the installation is finished so that you can check that everything is okay. As you can see, you can use Notepad++ normally and save the files that you create. Next, I am going to leave you with some tests I have done trying to run programs. I have tried to run the Undertale and Balatro games as well as the portable version of Photoshop. Unfortunately, the only game I have managed to run is Balatro, but the performance is a little bit poor. I show you the process of starting the game normally and with hardware acceleration so you can see that even using Turnip the performance is not enough to be considered playable. If you want, I can make videos about how to run Windows programs and native Termix with MoBox or Box64 Droid to have a much better performance. To try to run a game in the best possible way, I recommend you to adjust the resolution of Termix X11. You can do it from the app preferences. To see how to run things with hardware acceleration, go to the repository I leave in the description. I hope you like the video and leave your opinion in the comments. I will try to bring more videos about Wine, Box64, and running Windows games and apps on our Android device.